upon my knee, honey boy. Though you're only three, honey boy, you've no way of knowing, there's no way of showing what you mean to me, honey boy.
Well, I remember times. Going to that stucco house, and they had big parties there every Sunday, you know. Food, you know, cards, they'd play cards, they had table, card tables. There was a lot of work to do on the farm. So, you know, you're always doing something. I was driving a truck when I was 9 years old around the farm. I couldn't reach the pedals.
I still have you, sonny boy.
Yeah. Did you have any conflicts or disagreements with your parents when you were a teenager?
Oh, only about working. I didn't like that too well. But I wanted to be out with my friends, you know?
Right.
Because there was a lot of work to do.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody worked. Learn to work early in life. It's good training.
Yeah.
We didn't realize it all.
Did he read and write in Italian?
A little bit, yeah. Not much. Okay. My mother was the educated one.
Uh-huh.
She could read and write.
She could.
Yeah, and she learned English, all right, and, you know, learned to read English and write.
By herself.
By herself, yeah.
Wow. And you went across the country.
It was one of these felt line, you know, it was a really limousine. Camped all the time. We stayed at the most beautiful spots you ever saw. And I was handling all the navigation. I was doing all at 11 years of age. It was quite an experience for an 11-year-old kid.
What do you remember about your parents?
They just took care of me. The old man would say to me, I break up on this.
Yeah.
Everything I did some good, he said, good boy. It meant so much to me.
Yeah. Yeah. Wow.
Because I know what it meant to him. That was a prize expression from him. Good boy.
It's a good
experience. Mom wouldn't say too much. She did everything for me, though, you know.
Uh-huh.
She was a talker, though, but she didn't. She didn't praise me much.
She
know.
Didn't.
No, she just took it for granted that I would do it. You're doing great. That's fine. Yeah. That's what she should be doing.
Yeah.
They were lonely. Now I. Lonely too. So.
How did you meet Ann?
I didn't know her, but she knew me. But, you know, when she made that blind date with me, she was engaged.
So she
preferred me over that word. The guy she was engaged. He was a captain in the Army, you know. Yeah, very dignified type guy.
Very dignified.
Yeah, I was a student. He was an established, you know, captain. Yeah, yeah.
Did she tell you she was engaged?
Found out that later. Yeah.
What did you say to her when you found out?
I said, I'm a lucky guy. I saved her.
But you didn't say anything to Mom about it?
No.
So you didn't even bring it up to Mom?
No, because I didn't know about it. You know?
Did she, and you didn't, you never discussed
she never
it.
Mentioned it, yes.
Yeah. I can't believe
she
that.
She was smart.
Right.
She
didn't
mention. How did she break the engagement off?
Just like that. Well, she was darn cute. She was pretty,
yeah.
And she had a sense of humor. So that's how I got together.
I can't.
The women pick the men. They know what they're doing. They're very practical.
And how did you propose to her?
Yeah, on the beach. Monterey Beach. That was nice down there. So that's where I proposed. It was the summer of 46. We were married in 47.
Try, and you will only come to this conclusion. Love and marriage, they go together like the horse and carriage.
When I graduated medical school, there was an excitement. You know, it was terrific. Your classmates are real close. We started out with 100 and we finished with 60. We lost 40% of the class. So you had to work hard. That was a great experience for me.
Through early morning fog I see visions of the things to be, the pains that are withheld for me. I realize and I can see that suicide is painless.
I got there about 7 or 8 o'clock in the evening. They flew me in from Seoul to the MASH hospital on the central front lines, the 44th MASH. They flew me in there and brought me out to the hospital.
Wow.
I got to the compound. There must have been several hundred casualties lying on the ground. People wounded, soldiers wounded, on the ground, on the ground around the hospital. Wow. They were all tents, of course. First thing they said, go to work.
That's it.
There are patients all over the place there, you know.
Just get busy.
I went right to work, so I got there. Or cannon fire.
Yeah.
Rifle fire.
Yeah.
We have bullet wounds and fragment wounds from the artillery.
Right.
So you see that.
Yeah.
So you have to see fragment wounds or you see bullet wounds.
Uh-huh.
And then we had the helicopter division there.
You arrived.
It didn't stop for 12 hours later. Saved a lot of lives that way. Six surgeons, about six internists, and about 14 nurses. Six operating tables. And we saved a lot of lives that way.
And your routine there was pretty much 16 hours a day.
Oh yeah, all on call, all the time, all the time.
Yeah.
So we had. Wasn't that something?
How did you meet Connie?
And I asked her if she knew anybody who's Catholic. She immediately said, go see my mother. You see Catholic? She said she has a Holy Mary all over the house. So I drove up here. Her, I said, I'm coming up to see you.
What did she say?
Your daughter's a good friend of mine. Said, my wife just died and I'd like to, looking for a relationship. Came up here, I did all the talking. Well, she was shocked, she told me later. She was so shocked. The second day that I proposed to her, she said yes, like that. Even when I think about it now, I marvel at it. I didn't know I was doing all that stuff.
And we are so happy.
It's brought a lot of happiness to my life. Otherwise, I've been a kind of a lonely man. Yeah.
I used to sing on the farm. In fact, I used to write out the words so I'd memorize them. The neighbor farmer said, who's that guy singing? It would ring out through the countryside. Yeah.
I think I have a song coming on.
Lazy Mary, you better get up. She answered back, I am not able. Lazy Mary, you better. better get up. We need the sheets for the table. Lazy Mary, you smoke in bed. There's only one man you should marry. My advice to you would be is to pay attention to me. You'd better marry a fireman. He'll come and go, go and come. Zembala bomba manatena. Si chingapala bandazia de bomberia vigutsania. La 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 di la di shivrita bakala. We bomba na bombina chajakata. Oh bomba gambe voglio marita. Chomba la bagliotta gambe voglio marita. Mamma la voglio te gamme voglio marita. Hey!
I had a wonderful life.
Yeah.
Wonderful life.